मॉर्निंग 11th क्लास वी वर डूइंग चैप्टर 7 फ्रॉम योर टीआरजेन बुक प्रोडक्शन फंक्शन एंड रिटर्न्स टू अ फैक्टर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड दिस चैप्टर नाउ टुडे वी आर डूइंग क्वेश्चन आंसर्स एनसीईआरटी क्वेश्चन आंसर्स वी विल बी कवरिंग अप इन दिस वीडियो सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स यू कैन पॉज वीडियो यू कैन टेक योर नोटबुक पेन एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो मार्क इन द बुक Now, question number 1, explain the concept of a production function. So, the concept of production function, the relationship between physical input and physical output of a firm is generally referred to as production function. The general form of production function is Q equals to F X1 X2, where Q is output, quantity of output, X1, first input like labor and X2 another input like machine okay now the second in your book like this F it's LK L is for labor they have written L and for capital they have written K machinery comes into capital so you can write it in that way as well as you can write it in this way also like function is Q equals to F X1 X2 where X1 is input labor X2 is input like machinery or you can also write it QX equals to F LK L stands for labor and K for capital now the second question what is the total product of an input so total product of an input refers to total volume of goods and services produced by a firm with the given inputs during a specified period of time what is this this is the sum total of output produced by all units of input or it is the sum total of marginal product corresponding to each unit of the input we can say it in these two ways now question number 3 What is the average product of an input? So, what is the average product of an input? Average product of an input is per unit product of variable factors. It is calculated by dividing the total product by the units of variable factor. So, average product equals to total product divided by unit of variable factor. This is the formula for average product or AP in short form. Average product equals to total product divided by unit of variable factor. Then question number 4, what is the marginal product of an input? What is the marginal product of an input? Marginal product of an input is an addition to the total product when an additional unit of a variable function is employed. Marginal product of an input is an addition to the total product when an additional unit of a variable factor is employed. How this marginal product is calculated? Formula for this is change in output divided by change in input. Okay, change in output divided by change in input. So change in output is denoted by delta Q and change in input or change in labor is denoted by delta L. Okay, this is the formula for MP marginal product. Now question number 5. Explain the relationship between the marginal product and the total product of an input. So it can also be called as like this question could come in this form also explain the law of variable proportion with the help of total product and marginal product curves and explain the likely behavior of total product and marginal product when for increasing production only one input is increased while all other inputs are kept constant so this question is quite important and it could be asked in many ways as you have just seen it has been asked in four ways it could also be asked in the way like state the different phases of changes in total product and marginal product in the law of variable proportion also show the same in the single diagram so this is quite important question answer for this is, according to the law of variable proportion, when only one input is increased while all other inputs are kept constant, MP and TP, marginal product and total product, behave in the following manner. So how do they behave? We have studied about three phases also. So that is all written over here. When marginal product rises, point P1, like they have made the curve also. They have made curve for total product as well as for marginal product. So in the similar way, you have to do it in the notebook also with diagram. Only then you can fetch full marks, because it's a long answer question of 4 or 6 marks. So when marginal product rises till point P1, total product increases at increasing rate till point P. You can see it here. Okay, when MP is increasing, TP is also increasing till point P. But when MP product falls and remains positive till point V1, total product increases at a diminishing rate. Okay, see here, this total production is increasing up to point V, but marginal product is coming down. Okay, marginal product is coming, it remains same or it falls. Marginal product or total product, it's increasing, but it's increasing at a diminishing rate. This is second phase that we have studied. Then third point, when marginal product is zero. Where is marginal product zero? See here, marginal product is zero at point V1. So total product falls after that point. Means after this point, if we will see, total product is falling. Okay, so these were the three phases or variable law, variable proportion. In many form this question can be asked, so just do prepare it nicely. Then question number 6, explain the concept of the short run and the long run. So short run refers to the period of time in which a firm cannot change some of its factors like plant, machinery, building, etc. due to insufficiency of time, but can change any variable factor like labor, raw material. So in short run, there will be some factors of production that are fixed at predetermined levels. For example, a farmer may have fixed amount of land. In long run, a long run is a time period during which a firm can change all its factors of production, like machinery they can change, building they can change, organization they can change. So in other words, it's a period of time during which supplies can adjust itself to change in demand. Okay. Now note, here the terms long run and short run are functional and do not refer to a calendar, month or a year. This distinction depends merely upon how quickly factor inputs can be changed by producer in an industry. Okay. Now the next question, question number 7. Question number 7 is, what is the law of diminishing marginal product? So answer for this is, law of diminishing marginal product refers to when we apply more and more units of variable factor to given quantity of fixed factor, total product increases at a diminishing rate and marginal product falls. What is diminishing marginal product? The law of diminishing marginal product states that when we apply more and more units of variable factor to a given quantity of fixed factor, total product increases at a diminishing rate and marginal product falls. Okay. Now the next question, what is law of variable proportion, or define the law of variable proportion? Law of variable proportion, like we have done this, those three stages just now in that question, also in question number 6. Again we are doing it, but now we are doing it briefly. Okay. So the law of variable proportion states that as we increase the quantity of only one input, keeping other inputs fixed, the total product increases at an increasing rate in the beginning. Then it increases at a decreasing rate, and after a level, the output ultimately falls. Okay, these all were the three stages. This is the answer for this law of variable proportion. Now question number 9. There is a table. Table is given in this question, and table gives the total product schedule of labor. Find the corresponding average product, marginal product, schedule of labor. So labor is given and total product is given. Now we have to calculate MP first, marginal product, and then average product also we have to calculate. So we know the formulas. If we want to calculate average product, we will do PPL upon L, and if we want to calculate marginal product, then TPL upon delta TP upon delta L. So using these formulas we will calculate it. Like here total this was given, now we applied this formula 15 upon 115, 35 upon 2, 17.5. So this way we have calculated this average product. After this marginal product, how it will come? Delta TP upon delta L means change in L and change in TP. So total produce, how much is changing? It's 15. Then unit 1, then 35. How much it changed from 15 to 35? 20 it changes. So here it's 20. Then 15 to 35, 15. Or in that previous way, like we used to do marginal product, like we are deducting the previous unit from the next unit. In that way also we can calculate. So that will be easy if you will not use this formula. Like 35 minus 15, then 50 minus 35, then 40 minus 50 minus 10. Then this way this has been calculated. Okay. Now question number 10. The following table gives the average product schedule or labor. Find the total product and marginal product schedules. It is given that the total product is 0 at 0 level of employment. So this is given. L is given and average product is given. If AP and L are given, we can easily calculate TP. What will be the formula for TP? TP equals to L into AP. So that has been done here only. TP equals to L into AP. So 2 into 1, 2 into 3, 3 into 4, 4 into 4, 5 into 4, 6 into 3. So this way this has been calculated. Now then marginal product. Marginal product formula is this change in TP divided by change in L. Okay. So how much change in TP? 2 divided by 1, then change in TP 6 divided by 6 minus 2, then 12 minus 6. And 17 minus 12. In that way we can take out this marginal product. Okay. Next question number 11. Question number 11 is the following table gives the marginal product schedule of labor. It is also given that total product of labor is 0 at 0 level. Calculate the total and average product. So it's quite similar. In that way it will be done only. We will MP is given. So from here total product can be calculated. Total product is like it will be, now we will add up it, 3 plus 5, 8, then 8 plus 7, 15. This way we can calculate this TP, because we know that TP equals to summation of MPs. And after getting TP, we can easily calculate AP, because we know the formula for AP is TP upon L. So TP upon L means 3 upon 1, then 8 upon 2, then 15 upon 3, then 20 upon 4, then 23 upon 5. So this way we can calculate it easily. It's quite easy. Okay, now the next question, question number 12. Question number 12 is, let the product function of a firm be Q equals to 5 L half K half. If anything is having raised to power half, what it means? Means upon. Means that will come in upon. So here Q equals to 5 into 100, because Q, this L is given 100 and 100 units of K, so 100 power half in 100 power half. So if it's 100 power half means it will be, if anything raised to power half means square root of that. So square root of 100 is 10, square root of 100 is 10, and this way you can calculate the answer. Answer is 500. Okay. Now next, in like this is done according to me, NCERT questions are done. If any question is left, then you can check that, you can do that, and if you are facing any issue, you can ask me. This is all. Thank you.